first. So that one is 45, so that means this is 45. And that one is 60, that means this is 30. And then this one is, and this one are vertical angles, so this is also 45. And this angle and this angle are alternate interior angles, so this is also 45. So that means this is also 45, and this is 45 degrees. 45. And okay, so that is, what is this, 30? So this is 60. Yep. And the other angle is, okay, so this is 60. Now we can solve for the sides. So for 45, 45, we're given the hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse is, I use another color. No, it's not. Maybe red. Okay. So we're given the hypotenuse 4. So 4 is just, this 4 is equal to x square root of 2. So you divide both sides by square root of 2. Then x is equal to 4 square root of 2. And then you rationalize that, multiply by square root of 2. Then that is 4 square root of 2 over 2. So x is just equal to 2 square root of 2. So this one is 2. I'm answering it. 2 square root of 2.
Yeah, right.
2 square root of 2. Okay? Am I right? Because from here, so our x is square, x is 2 square root of 2. 4. So divide by square root of 2, so that is, and then you rationalize that, 4 square root of 2 over 2, 2 square. Okay, then we already have, for our 30, 60, 90 triangle, the opposite of 30 is 2 square root of 2, so that means our x is 2 square root of 2. Therefore, our, the side opposite to 60 degrees is just 2 square root of 2 times square root of 3. So this is 2 square root of 6. And the hypotenuse is 2, our x is square root of 2, 2 times 2 square root of 2, that is 4 square root of 2. I made it faster.
Yeah.
Okay, so that leg is, the next triangle is 45, 45, 90. So one leg is 2 square root of 6, so that means this is 2 square root of 6, 2. And then x square root of 2. So this hypotenuse is, what's this? 2 square root of 6 times square root of 2. So this is just equal to 2 square root of 12. But 12 can be written as 4 times 3, right? So that is 2 square root of 4 times 3. So this is, square root of 4 is 2 times 2, that is 4 square root of 3. So this side is, this one, is 4 square root of 3. Then, we can find the leg from there, the two legs. Oh, that's so, can you still understand it?
What?
I mean, my writings, because I,
messy.
Okay. Be sure you follow. So we got the hypotenuse here, which is 4 square root of 3, and the next triangle is 45, 45. So we divide that by square root of 2 to find the legs. So that is 4 square root of 3. To solve for x, divide by square root of 2. So this is 4 square root of 3 over square root of 2, and then we rationalize, so that is 4 square root of 6 over 2, that is 2 square root of 6. So that means this one, this leg here, and this leg here, they're both 2 square root of 6. Let me change that. So this is 2 square root of 6, and this leg 2 is 2 square root of 6. Okay, so the last two triangles, that one is angle bisector. So this one is an equilateral triangle, the whole one, the whole triangle. This one, because they have the same angles, 60, 60, 60.
Yeah.
So that means the sides are equal. So if that is 2 square root of 6, then that means this is also, this is 2 square root of 6. This is 2 square root of 6. Then that is the hypotenuse. Then we can solve for this one. So 30, 60, 90. We can solve for x here. So 2 square root 2x is equal to 2 square root of 6 divided by 2, so x is equal to square root of 6. So this is square root of 6 times square root of 3. So this is square root of 18. Can we further? 18 can be written as 9 times 2. So this is square root of 9 times 2. So this is just 3 square root of 2. This one, this leg here. Let me draw that. So it won't be confusing for you. Is that, why do I have the, oh my gosh. I'm drawing it so be confusing. So this is 2 square root of 6, 2 square root of 6, and this is 3 square root of 2. 30, 60, and this is square root of 6 and square root of 6. You got that?